So I wanted to make this video to say thank you to a ton of people. Like, there's really probably hundreds, but I'm probably not going to get through all of the names. So, as you guys know, over the years, well, the past 4 or 5, I've gotten really good at flying helicopters. I've picked up and gone through a couple different sponsors, and it's been incredible. It's been a ton of work, though, like a lot. So I wanted to go through and thank some people and kind of tell a story about how I've gotten to this point, like where I started from, and explain how to like do what I did. I guess I should start off by saying that my first helicopter event I ever went to was IRCHA 2015, and when I went there, it was incredible. Like, at that point, I wasn't really flying helicopters much. I was just starting to get into it, and I started really liking them. And then a little bit after that, I had gotten my first like real big helicopter after using the simulator for a very long time. It was a Century Hawk Nitro. It was used. I bought it from the like ceiling of my old local hobby shop, and it was not that great. So, working with that machine, it taught me a lot about flybarless systems and gyros and setups and servos and stuff. And eventually I did crash that. It wasn't my fault though, it broke. I guess I say that about a lot of stuff though. So, a little bit after that, I got what was probably my first like 3D heli. It was around 2016. I got a Walkera V450, which was a ready to fly 450 size helicopter, and it flew pretty good. It did not crash very well though, and I crashed it a lot. So that taught me more and more about like the simple maneuvers and stuff. And at the same time, I should bring up like how I was actually learning the maneuvers. So around that time, I started watching YouTube videos and stuff on how to do these maneuvers. To be more specific, I started watching Freddy Cordova's videos because he did a lot of simulator videos back then on how to do those maneuvers on good old Phoenix 5.5. And I started working my way up and learning them one at a time, and racking up thousands of hours of simulator time, and it was a lot of work. So a couple months or maybe a year or so after that, I had gotten a Blade 500. It was Flybird at the time, and like it was my first decent machine. Like, it was actually like somewhat hobby grade. The only downside is the main gears suck. So working with that, I flew it a lot. I had learned a lot about setting up a tail gyro with that machine because it was a pain to get it to fly right. And then, like, I eventually switched it to flybarless and, you know, just kept on practicing and practicing, lots of simulator time. And eventually I did my first, like, I guess you could say, like, public flight or so. Like, I did the IRCHA's Got Talent in 2017 in front of a lot of people. And it was my first time flying in front of a large group of people, like in a designated competition, you could say. And it was an incredible experience. Shortly after IRCHA 2017, I had been like surpassing what the Blade 500 was able to do. And I was talking to some people about it. And then one day, a guy named Joe Biller posted in the Hangout. He posted that he had a T-Rex 600 for someone who needed a better machine that couldn't really afford it and wanted to be able to progress more. And then a bunch of people pitched in and they said, "Hey, I think Brendan could really use this." And I got it. Joe sent it to me. And then John Maynard, he posted in the Hangout and he said, "Hey, Joe just gave Brendan this helicopter. Let's help him get it set up," which was very kind of him. And then I was just astonished by the amount of people that came and helped out. We had Shannon Turner, who gave me servos and a motor. We had Frank, who gave me an Icon 2. Josh Yarbrough gave me an ESC. And Derek Townsend gave me blades. Alan Butler, a canopy. And John just kind of like pushed everyone to come and help me out. And it was amazing. So eventually I did get that running, and like I made a ton of progression on that machine. and like I was starting to slowly work my way up to bigger models, and because of that machine, I got my first sponsorship, well, first helicopter sponsorship. I got into Team Compass, and then I got my first 700 class helicopter, which was the Kronos, also notorious for its main gear failures. But that might be my fault. So around 2017-2018, I started to get a little more popularity. Like, I started getting a couple sponsors. Like, I got picked up by Scorpion, I believe it was in 2018, like early 2018. And I've had a lot of fun on that team. There were a lot of great guys, and I just loved the power plants. And then, like, when I was flying the Blade 500 still, I had gotten onto Team Tesla Servos. They're not around anymore, but they're still great servos, and like I've had my one set inside my helicopters for like 3 or 4 years now, and they've not broken yet. Like, it's been through dozens of crashes and like thousands of flights, and they just don't break. Urcha 2018. I did my first demo hour, which was a huge thing for me. Like, I always wanted to do that. So I had been on Team Scorpion at the time, and I did a demo flight for them up on the front line with my friend Donnie Pesh. And we just did a duo flight, and it was awesome. So 2019 creeps around, and like I've started getting really good because I got admitted into the XFC competition. So I had to do an atrocious amount of practice, and probably this year is where I made the most improvement. Like, I went from being good to actually like using a lot of transitions and stuff, so I'm actually starting to get really good, and my flights just flow better than they used to. So with that, I also got more experience in making flights to music. I'd been doing that for all these past couple of years because I just enjoyed it, but like I got to finally put that to the test and make an awesome flight to music. And it was truly an incredible experience. I did my first competition there, and I got 6th place in the finalists, which was huge for me. Like, this is where I wanted to be. Like, I started out just a new pilot flying a little 450 around my backyard, and I worked my way up to being in a national competition, and it was a huge moment for me. I should also mention, in 2019, this year, I also got onto Team A-Main, which was amazing, because they let me travel, and I got to hang out with the guys, and it's just an overall amazing experience with these people. Let's talk about some of my inspirations. People who have pushed me to get better, and people who I thought were amazing pilots, and I kind of like followed in their footsteps. Like, I was trying to be like them, or I was inspired by them. So, like, right when I was getting into it, like, around 5-6 years ago, I watched a lot of videos from Alan Sabo, like, probably more than I should have. Like, just seeing the TRX-800 all the time, doing crazy shit, that was awesome. And then over time, like, I started watching more and more videos, I started learning about who the people were. Like, Daniel Katsev and Ofik Katsev were huge inspirations for me as well. I just love their flying styles. And then also you had Bobby Watts and Kyle Dahl, Kyle Stacey, and just more and more I just kept on like being so influenced by their flying. It was incredible to watch and just amazing. But yeah, that's a little bit of background on where I started and where I've come in the past couple of years as far as flying my helicopters. And just a huge thank you to everyone that helped push me to become a better pilot. There's literally too many people to list off. Like, there's been so many people that have either helped me with my machines or like cheered for me at events or just, you know, commented on my posts, like nice flying, stuff like that. There's like too many people to list, but like I want to say thank you to all of you for helping me get this far, because this was my ultimate goal. I started 5-6 years ago, and I was seeing the videos of the pros, and I'm like, I want to do that one day. And I couldn't have done it without you guys. Now I'm going to include a little bit of a small compilation of, like, my flying when I started up to where I am now. Thank you to all of you. I really appreciate all the support over the past couple of years and the years to come. And I can't wait for what the 2020 season is going to bring.
Ayo, drop that shit.